Good morning, friends. This is Sanjay Agarwal. I'm joined by these two young girls. So they have just got the award. We have a FICCI Cascade event happening at the FICCI Federation House. So this was about global challenges of illicit trade and how to tackle the way forward. It's about preventing smuggling. So there was a contest, and today Akanksha is with me on the right hand side and Riya is with me on the left hand side. So they have got they have given three awards, 1, 2, and 3, right? So the first one is Akanksha. She studies in Amity, she's doing journalism, and Riya is a student of data science. So first I think we'll go to Riya and then to Akanksha, as it in the auditorium they announced the number three, you know. So number three, Riya, how do you feel to get this award today?
I feel very honorable actually, and it's very pleasurable moment after getting an award from a very own person, and who is the owner of FICCI. And even though I don't think so that I will get this award, it was like very very unpredictable.
And how many people participated? Kitne log ne isme? Kitne log the?
Even yeah, there are many people. There are many people. Yeah.
100?
I don't know the actual number, but there are many people. After even I was not even like, it's just a dream after meeting him and getting an award from him. It's even a first award, I guess, of me getting by him, like maybe
many more.
Yeah, many more to come.
The innings have started, so you've got a way forward is you'd get many awards. So it's now to the sweet girl, Akanksha. She's a little nervous, but I think unka sunke to chala gaya nervousness, right? So there's no question from my side. You tell about yourself, right? Please.
Okay, so as you all know that my name is Akanksha Puri, and first of all, first position milna is kind of thoda sa shocking and काफ़ी unpredicting था, but when I got this, I'm so much
excited. I can see that you're excited. I just wanted to know, another thing was ये award अभी आपको आज मिला है in front of so many people, you know.
Yeah.
This is about smuggling. Hmm. So what do you feel about smuggling? How do you feel about, you know, India mein whatever is happening?
बहुत तरह की smuggling होती है, like gold की smuggling है, काफी चीजों में like biscuits और chocolate balls के shape में smuggling होती है.
You watched the movie, I believe.
Yeah.
The movie you've seen.
Yeah. नहीं अभी आई ना crew, उसमें था.
Crew.
Yeah. तो ये चीज रोकनी चाहिए, जो भी law में है या जो भी ऐसे companies हैं जो इसको रोक रही हैं, and it is a great initiative.
मेरा फिर जस्ट सवाल है, वी जस्ट सॉ योर एंट्री, सो दैट वाज व्हाट पोस्टर डिड यू मेक? दैट वाज अ पोस्टर कॉन्टेस्ट, तो आप उसके बारे में यू वांट टू से समथिंग?
ओके, तो वो एक जस्टिस का तराजू टाइप्स है, जिसमें ये है कि जो लॉ के लोग हैं वो अंधे ना हों इस चीज़ को लेके, एंड वो अपनी आँखें खोलें टूवर्ड्स द स्मगलिंग एंड जस्टिस दिलाएं लोगों को.
वंडरफुल. एंड आई थिंक Akanksha, इवन आई वॉच दैट मूवी. We went for the press show. So when these three girls, you know, Kareena and Tabu and who's the third one? Kirti.
Yeah, Kirti.
So when they got that idea of doing that smuggling chocolate, go, you know, running gold me and all that stuff. So I was really feeling, ki, what are they showing? Because I said this will give to rise to people, you know. And me thi ke they brought the, it's something like the airline, you know, this kind of thing. So but. I was really feeling my views ki aise cheez jo dikhate hain when we are showing crime, that gives rise to more crime. To aapka kya khayal hai? Aapne movie dekhi hai Crew? Nahi dekhi, but how do you feel ki agar crime dikha rahe hain, we have crime patrol and so many things, to does it help in usko prevent karta hai ya usko aur badhava deta hai?
अगर इफ़ समवन इज़ शोइंग अस कि बहुत बेकार, बहुत अच्छी तरीके से वो चोरी कर रहे हैं किसी मूवीज़ में, या फिर किसी मूवीज़ में ये दिखा रहे हैं कि वो स्मगल कर रहे हैं जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ मनी, जस्ट तो इट डजेंट हेल्प अस. इवन दो दे एज प्रोफेसर अनुज कुमार सर सेड दैट कि
ज़्यादातर लोग यहाँ पे पॉवर्टी लाइन ब्लो लाइन है, जिन्हें समझ नहीं आ सकता बिल्कुल भी कि हम सही कर रहे हैं हम गलत कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि उनके आइडल ये कर रहे हैं, ऐसा सिखा रहे हैं उनको। तो बेसिकली ये चीज़ बहुत गलत है कि अगर हम स्मगल करें उनको देख के। तो बॉलीवुड और ये सारी चीज़ों को, प्लेटफॉर्म को, जो बड़े प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं उन्हें हमेशा से ये दिखाना चाहिए कि ये चीज़ हमेशा से गलत रही है और हमें बिल्कुल भी ये चीज़ नहीं करनी चाहिए।
गुड, एंड एनीथिंग यू वांट टू शेयर योर व्यूज अबाउट जो आज का इवेंट है, दिस इज अबाउट इलिसिट ट्रेड, यू नो फिकी इज द वन ऑफ द नोडल, it's the industry body, it's one
Shapuri.
I'm 40% by 95-96, and by 2012-13 it had become 62% of GDP. So this rise in the black economy implies a rise in the illegality in society. This rising illegality is what is linked to the illicit flows. So how does rising illegality take place in society? That takes place because there's a triad underlying the black income generation. The triad consists of the corrupt businessmen, the corrupt political class, and the corrupt executive. If this triad doesn't exist, black income generation would not exist. And there's a book by Covell, Professor Covell from Daniel School of Economics, 1990. He showed that black income generation is a joint product between the private sector and the public sector. In fact, he goes to the extent of saying, if the private sector didn't exist, then there would be no black income generation. I don't agree with that fully, but the triad is there. This triad is what underlies the illegality that takes place. So therefore, in a sense, checking black income generation and illicit trade becomes a political question. Economy implies illegality. Illegality in a variety of activities. It could be in legal activities, it could be in illegal activities. As I said, it is generated through under-invoicing of revenue and over-invoicing of cost. So for instance, your labor cost, your raw material cost, they are over-invoiced. Your price and quantity, because price into quantity is revenue. So price is under-invoiced, price is under-invoiced and quantity is under-invoiced. So therefore, you have under-invoicing of revenue and over-invoicing of cost. These are factors. So what it implies is that your wage cost is shown to be higher than what it is. So like in Satyam's case, your 12,000 additional employees that were actually not there. So the 12,000 employees' wages were being siphoned out. You know, similarly, say in Noida, there's a friend of mine who teaches in a college there, and he has to carry half his salary in cash before he gets the UGC salary. So actually his wage is lower than what the actual wage is. So in other words, you have the under-invoicing of both price and quantity. So therefore, what you find is that the black incomes are actually profit incomes. They are property incomes, what are broadly called profit, interest, rent, and dividend. So in the Indian context, what happens is that the profits are shown to be lower, wage costs are shown to be higher. So the distribution of national income shifts in favor of profits. So actually, the white profits that are generated, those are understated. And that's why profit to wage ratio is understated. And when that happens, it has major implications. Like I argued that we are losing 5% rate of growth because the investment productivity is much lower than what it could be in the economy. So there are major implications of this. So the definition that I've given is black income.